First thing I've got to say, I adore your hair.
You know what? Una did it.
No.
Yeah, obviously, me and Una are very, 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 very good mates after Game of Thrones. And I went to her house and I was like, look, I look like I'm in the 80s. Can we do something? And I'm terrible at hair. And so she just whipped the victory curls up.
She's a lady of many, many, many talents.
Done.
Bada bing, bada boom.
Gathering Goddess, they supplied me with this epic outfit. I think it's epic.
Fantastic. I was about to talk to you about it. So where is this from? Which decade in history?
The 80s. Love the 80s, yes. I was born in 84. And what I love about Gathering Goddess is they have such unique things. I mean, utterly unique. And the restoration is fantastic. And when you go to the shop, it's like playing dress up. You know when you go to posh boutiques and they treat you like...
Oh, darling.
No. It's like they look at you and they're like, she's not going to be able to afford this. So they think you're going to steal stuff. See, I'm not joking. I've had this a lot in my life. And there, they're just like, come in. It's like women and it's fantastic and it's dress up and beautiful pieces that I've never seen anywhere.
And I guess like reliving your childhood, playing dress up, as you said. Have fun.
They are. I was going to go for the Gatsby thing, but Una's got that covered, so I thought 80s.
Now tell me about Gatsby. Are you a massive fan of the film and the book?
I loved the book. I studied it when I was at school. It's an amazing book about the American dream. I know that we watched it when I was at school, but I've forgotten it. I can't remember what this one in particular is like, but I'm really excited about the new one.
Of course, that's out soon.
Carey Mulligan, I think she's a fantastic actress, so I can't wait to see that.
Will you be watching this one tonight, the 74?
Yes, I'm going to have a cocktail, and then I'm going to go and watch the film.
Go all out, why not? Tell me about Game of Thrones. Are you enjoying being part of that?
Mate, I've met so many amazing people on this show, and filming it is so mad. Like, I've had to do, like, for this one, I had to learn to skin a rabbit. When would you ever have to do that in life? I mean, unless you're going all out and I'm going to go skin some rabbits today. But that's what's great about these jobs that push you to do something that maybe you wouldn't ordinarily do, like skinning 40 rabbits in a day.
What is the appeal of Game of Thrones? Why is it such a massive success?
Well, like, a lot of life is about power and power struggles. And it's kind of what we would, for me, it's a bit like how we would imagine life to have been, but with that element of magic to kind of keep us there. And, you know, it's got fantastic sex scenes and death scenes. And I like the fact anyone might die. There's no favoritism. It's much more like life that anyone at any moment might die.
You're all vulnerable and human.
Yes, exactly.
And how long do you reckon it can go on for? There's talk of it just sort of being an almost endless stream of series.
I don't know. I mean, I imagine because he's obsessed with the number 7, even though he split the two books, the three into two parts, my logical conclusion is that he'd stop at 7, but... Who knows?
Now, obviously, you love your character, but who else in Game of Thrones do you kind of really admire and think is an amazing person?
Gwen's character. I always get her name wrong. Brianna. What did you say, Ross?
Brienne of Tarth.
Yes. Brienne of Tarth. She's,
Ross is a fan.
She's my favourite, definitely.
Tell me why.
Because she represents to me what a lot of women feel in the man's world, which is to be respected, you have to be 10 times better than a guy, and still you're still treated like that, you know. And she's not your average beautiful woman. I don't know, it's the whole world of maybe being in acting as well. She calls into something in my feminist heart.
So why, you're a feminist then?
Obviously.
Do you think we're ever going to reach equality?
I'm hoping so. I've got a band called Molotov Jukebox, and our next video comes out on Monday, and I'm hoping before we finalise the final edit, that we can give a percentage of that towards charities that stop genital mutilation.
Fantastic. Are you a singer in this band?
Yes, and I play the accordion, and we're like a 6-piece.
That is the coolest instrument in the world.
It's heavy, man. I can never wear heels when I play. I've got to be barefoot.
So how does this all jumble together to make up your life? You've got your music going on,
yes.
Your Game of Thrones.
Yes.
What takes priority? Would you balance?
Neither. I mean, it's just trying to balance it. Because music gets booked up so much in advance. Like, they've already booked up the festivals. So February, you know, they're asking me, can we have dates? And I'm like, oh, can we push it back a bit? Because I don't know about some jobs. So it's about managing time. But I've got an amazing agent at Curtis Brown. And I've got an amazing manager, Sirius. So
you don't have the same agent that does your music and your acting? No, you keep it separate?
Yeah, you have to. It's different spheres. They work so hard that you can only really... be good at one thing, I think.
Oh, cool. You're an amazing woman. You've got your the feminist, musical, acting, everything.
Thank you.
Go and have a cocktail and enjoy the film.
See you later.
See you later.
Hopefully, please.